is, and again, the devastation of what it just almost cannot be overstated. And yes, later in the war, this might be common, but at this time, this is really where total war is manifested. And interesting, our total war theory comes from the American Civil War. You look at the growth of total war from the U.S. Civil War through something called the Boer War in South Africa and the Brits onto World War I and then World War II, really manifesting an idea called total war. So Operation Sea Lion would be canceled. The German Air Force was repelled, and Britain was saved. Again, the damages were tremendous, tremendous. And we talked about it earlier, some reasons why it was canceled. A, the German Air Force is just sustaining far too many losses. That was a big problem. It didn't appear this was going to be viable, and more importantly, Adolf Hitler knew he had to save his Air Force for his next move. What was his next move, remember? Where was he going next? Off to Russia. So Russia is always in the back of his mind at all times. Like I said, always sought negotiations. And I really, the more I read of this, the more I'm just convinced that that was the plan. It really was. Seeking these negotiations, offering to allow Britain to maintain their colonies. What Adolf Hitler was interested in was a return of World War I colonies that were lost, and that would be in Africa, modern-day Togo, and modern-day Namibia. You have a comment, sir?
I truly believe that Hitler had a lot of respect for England, and he was convinced that he could convince their people to go against their government if he could just cause enough damage.
And you know, that's a pretty good strategy. I like the way Ralph worded it. He was convinced that he could convince their people. Well, maybe he had not heard enough words from Churchill. Because I think Churchill verbally would have put a stop to about anything.
They're both great orators.
Very true. So we look at this decisive battle, yet very costly on both sides. Yes, Germany would lose. Yes, Britain would win. But winning and losing, as we say, it's rarely a football game. It often creates losers on both sides. And remember, neither side truly has the ability to reproduce their planes. That ability would come. Lend-lease would come. Of course, the United States would find their way into the war. But none of that's happened yet. None of that has happened yet. So we look at just these numbers, and we see some tremendous. If you recall, that's about a 60% casualty rate on their aircraft, which frankly were more important or more valuable than pilots, because the pilots could be replaced, the aircraft could not. So we see there is a tremendous cost to this. Last 300 years, Britain has been the colonizer. They have been the aggressor. Except for those, pasty old Americans that kicked them off the continent. They pretty much have had their way around the globe. The British Empire still, of course, maintained the crown jewel of India, not knowing they would lose that 9 years later. But Britain had not been in a position where their very existence was threatened. They've always been the one doing the threatening. George has a wonderful thesis in all of his classes. Pretty much everything in history is Britain's fault.
But didn't Britain always count on the United States to bail them out if they really got into trouble?
You know, again, that's a subject. I'm not convinced of that at this time. Remember, this is September of 1940. you just don't know what the future is going to be. A, Roosevelt may not get elected. Roosevelt is attempting a third term, which has never been done. You do not have any concrete agreements. And remember, we're still in the midst of a Great Depression. By no means is our economy in any type of war manufacturing. Our mobilization is, Roosevelt would institute a draft, but by no means are we mobilized. So at this time, at this day, the United States, it had help available, not much at all. Never envisioned us becoming the arsenal of democracy that indeed would take place.
And you're correct in a way. In the post-World War II world, we have supported the British on their adventures. But prior to this time, we were really reluctant to jump in. You gotta remember that the 1920s and the 1930s, our foreign policy is pretty much, let's hide behind the shores and not do too much. And that's why Hitler was able to flourish through the 30s. We really never took him to task. So we were actually a kind of a complicit actor in the rise of the fascism.
Well, today is a very important day for me. 68 years ago, we left my hometown, escaped the Russians, but one day, otherwise there would have been rape of my sisters, my mother, my grandmother, and everybody else, which was female. And not just rape, gang rape, and then slaughter. And the German women knew that. They were frightened by it. My aunt, she lost her husband in Russia, and lost a son on the third day of Barbarossa. So she was all alone in Berlin. So we left, we tried on the 19th of January, 1945. People came out of the theaters and out of the bars and said, well, you guys go on. You go on your way to the train station. Well, we had no luck because it was absolute chaos. Babies inside, mothers outside, and vice versa. We were a party of 15 people, and we did not want to leave anybody behind, so we just went home. 2 days later, we tried again, and my dad worked in a defense industry. We were building ships and tanks. He sent us two men to sort of keep our rear open to be able to get in at one rush. That was the luckiest day of our life, because a day later, the Russians were in my hometown. One day. I was 9 years old. I remember virtually every speech Hitler gave. And some of them were ugly speeches from the Germans. I was never for national socialism. I was never for communism. And that's the reason why I came to the United States. They had a program here. It was sort of a Marshall Plan for civilians. Was called Refugees from Communism. And I fell under that category. And was very happy I took advantage of it.
Thank you. War has two dimensions to it. You see it from the side of the victors, but often it's the side that we don't hear, the stuff that we don't hear. And I'm glad you're able to share this with us. Because you don't understand all of that, I'm glad you're here with the class. Any other questions?